Today I want to talk about a common issue that a lot of copywriters run into when they start writing cold emails, which is sending a landing page when you should be sending a concise email to customers. I want to take you into the inbox and show you this email, and let's go through how we can improve it. So here's the email that's being sent out. Off the bat, the font looks really weird. And it's not just this email. If we scroll up, his entire question, you know, hey Alex, thanks for uploading great videos on YouTube. Well, thank you for watching them. I guess I have to make a video on the correct fonts to use in your email inbox. The answer is the default fonts. It looks like this email is scrawled onto some Dead Sea Scrolls. Okay, off the bat, hi Joe, exclamation point, hope your week's going well. I read the testimonial Fiona on your site. With her gentle yet focused approach, Joe has encouraged me to really examine my goals and get, so I would stop reading right there. It's just too much. But actually I'd stop reading with the font thing, but I'm ignoring the font for now. Let's take this email over to Google Docs and we'll rebuild it. All right, so here's the email. Easiest way to get stuff in a normal font is to go over and just hit clear formatting. I wouldn't start off with an exclamation point. The good thing about this email is a lot of the copy is usable. What we're mainly gonna be doing in this review is removing stuff. First thing, hope your week's going well. I read the testimonial of Fiona on your site. With her gentle yet focused approach, Joe encouraged me to really examine my goals and get, okay. So I would just remove this. Great customization here. If you can call out a specific testimonial or a specific client, you don't have to go into more detail about it. Joe knows her testimonials better than you do. So you copy pasting a testimonial in there isn't showing her anything that she doesn't already know and just slows the whole email down. I was looking at your website and there are some key changes you can make to win more clients each month. My guess is that right now, three biggest wins for your business would be the three biggest wins. Why is it that all these emails have typos in them? Here's a challenge for you, all right? Send me a cold email, no typos, and I'll send you a special gift, all right? Send that email to alex@experiment27.com. I think just getting those bare minimums, I'll give you a certificate, certified typo free. All right, my guess is that right now the three biggest wins for your business would be getting more signups for your 20-minute consultation, winning ideal clients for your career coaching, clients who understand the value of your coaching, increasing registrations for your online workshops. I know all three of these are subtly different, but they're the exact same thing. They're all going for more clients or more coaching clients. So I'm anti-bullet points in emails as well, because it makes it look like a landing page. This and then the testimonials, which you put at the bottom of this email, really slow this thing down. Sending people the exact testimonials and reviews, it's rough. Put these on your site for sure. You could take this whole email and put it into Squarespace and have a landing page. If somebody pulls out their cell phone and they're reading an email, they don't want to see all these testimonials. They'll go to your site if they want to see more info. The point of an email is to raise awareness that you exist and get them to meeting. You don't need these testimonials to do that. The other thing, call to action on this, if you're interested, would it be okay to send you a few ideas on how we could help? You already sent the ideas using the bullet points, so I don't know why that was in there. So we'll change the CTA. I was looking at your website and assuming your main goal is to attract more coaching clients, there are some key changes you can make to win more every month. So this was, assuming your main goal is to attract more coaching clients, that's taking those three bullet points and condensing them down to, what is that, 9 words? Recently, I like contractions to save time, so changing we have to we've and other things like that, because I think it makes it look more human. If you don't talk in contractions, I would keep it the same way. Or if you're unable to use contractions like data or Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg. We've worked with a real estate consultant and finance coach to achieve the same results using web design. I'll change regards to thanks as well. I'm always trying to push to be more human and more real in these emails. If you sign all your emails off with regards, do it. Use best, use whatever you normally use. I like thanks, it seems more casual to me. So here's what we're looking at. Hi Joe, came across your name on a list of top personal development coaches and read the testimonial of Fiona on your site. You're doing a great service to people. I was looking at the page and assuming your main goal is to attract more coaching clients, there are some changes you can make. Recently we've worked with a real estate consultant and a finance coach to achieve the same results using web design, and I'd be happy to send over some case studies. Wanna hop on a call? Let me know and I can send over a few times. Have a ton of free ideas to share. Thanks, Nishat. And I think just fix the font here and we will be done. Good to send. If you found this valuable, I'd love if you would share it with a friend or two. Also, if you need help writing sales emails for your agency or anything involving sales or lead generation, please reach out to experiment27.com. We'd love to help. Thanks.